Welcome to the Small Cases Show. I'm your host, Anupam Gupta. Today's episode is about smart beta. Since the past few years, the investing world has been abuzz with a big debate about passive investing versus active investing. But what if you could invest in a product that gives you best of both worlds? Yes, I'm talking about smart beta. To explain this and much more, my guest for this episode is Anugrah Srivastav, founder at Smallcase. Anugrah, welcome to the show. Thank you so much for joining us. Let's get right into this debate, right? What is active? What is passive? What's been this debate about in the last 10 years?
Sure. Thanks a lot for inviting me, Anupam. So according to me, like, every strategy can be executed in either active manner or passive manner, right? So let's quickly take an example to understand this so that all the viewers can quickly understand. For example, let's say you want to go from one place to another place. Let's say you want to go from Powai to Marine Drive in Bombay, right? There are two ways of going about it. You can just open Google Maps, put in Marine Drive, and just follow the path to reach to Marine Drive, right? So in this case, you have just taken the decision to follow a particular path only once, right? You've just taken the decision, okay, Google Maps showed this path, I'm going to follow this particular path, right? Or the other way could be that you talk to a lot of localites, figure out how do you want to reach there, either take a cab halfway, then take a metro or take a local, something like that, right? So in this case, you are actually constantly evaluating your decisions and again taking a new decision to follow a particular path, right? Because you want to shorten the time taken to reach the particular destination, right? This is actually the difference between passive investing and active investing, right? In passive investing, you always follow a predefined path or strategy, right? And very rarely review it, okay? And in case of active investing, you're constantly thinking or churning your portfolios, right? Now, there can be merits and demerits in both of them, and that's why we have a debate about it, right? So let's understand that how it works in the world of finance, right? Let's say if you want to buy five stocks from banking sector, okay? The passive way of doing this is that you buy the portfolio today and probably look at it once in a while, let's say once a year type, that if everything is right with the portfolio, or probably how much money you're making in the portfolio, right? Or the active way of doing it would be after buying the five stocks today, right? You are constantly evaluating, do I need to drop a particular stock or do I need to add a stock. The decision could be triggered by, let's say, the government's announcement of recapitalization plan or the GDP statistics which comes out every quarter, or for that matter could be anything, right? The NPA numbers of the banks, right? So you're re-evaluating constantly, right? So that's why active investing is always very, very risky, because if there are more decisions to take, the probability of the decisions going wrong is also increasing simultaneously, right? So it's more involved, more risky way of investing, while passive is more chilled out and relaxed way of investing, right? So that's why, like, generally people prefer passive way of investing also.
I can tell you that going from Marine Drive to Powai is not chilled out by any man.
but yeah, that's exactly what is
the... I get what you're saying.
Yeah.
What's smart beta?
Yeah. Okay. So I think before we go into smart beta, right, I would just want to say that what are probably the problems, that why, what is the need of a smart beta in the very first place, right? Because if you're actively managing something, right, you're constantly churning the portfolio. And anyone who has traded would know that if you churn the portfolio, the cost always goes up, right? And at the same time, it's more risky, as you mentioned, right? And in case of passive also, there could be some problems if you completely stop looking at the portfolio. Who knows what's going to happen tomorrow in the stock market, right? So that's why we say, or we feel, that there is a need for a strategy which is somewhere between the active and passive, and which is what we call the smart way, or probably the smart beta way of investing, right? So once we determine that, okay, probably this is the way of investing, and just some data points to make the case very strong, right? A smart beta is something which is picking up very phenomenally across the globe. In 2010, actually the total assets which were sort of parked into smart beta strategies, I think, was around $100 billion, but today it has grown to almost, I think, around $800 billion, right? So that's like a cumulative growth of around 25 to 26%, right? So that's huge. So globally, people are getting more and more inclined towards a smart beta strategies, right? So beta, whenever we talk about beta, we can use it for a particular security, be it ETF or for that matter mutual fund or stock also, or it could be for a portfolio also, right? But it is always talking that what is the risk. By risk, I mean what could be the possible variation in the price or NAV of that particular security versus the benchmark with which we are calculating the beta, right? So a beta, let's say, if we say the beta of a stock is 2, right? It means that generally it is twice as risky as Nifty, right? In loose terms, it technically might mean a lot more things.
A high beta stock is more risky than a low beta stock,
yeah,
roughly.
Yeah, yeah. And when we say that it is risky, it means that it's going to be more volatile, right? So it's like if Nifty goes up by 10%, it can go up by 20%. If it's coming down by 10, it might come down by 20. It's just that the movement in the stock is going to be twice as much as compared to the Nifty.
Yes.
And a low beta stock means that the movement is going to be lesser compared to the market. And that's why we say it is less risky, because by risk we mean the movement.
So that's beta.
Yeah, okay. That's beta.
How does smart beta work?
Yeah. So the tricky thing to understand is that beta is the risk, right? And in investing, risk and return always go together, right? If you increase the risk, you are increasing the return. And if I say that increase the risk, you would feel that you need to invest into high beta stocks, because just a moment back we defined that risk means beta, right? But the magic happens when you actually don't increase the risk but increase the returns.
That's actually possible.
Yeah, that's okay. Actually possible, and that's what smart beta is all about, right?
Okay, Anugrah, this is so much of information to process: active investing, passive investing, smart beta. Tell us something about yourself, your educational background, and how you founded Smallcases.
So I've graduated from IIT Kharagpur. I have completed my master's in economics from there. I've also completed the CFA. And after college, I joined Nomura. It's a Japanese investment bank. There I was sort of doing a similar work. I was building thematic portfolios and indices for institutional clients. Something like if something is happening in Australia, how it's going to impact Japan, or all those majorly on global parameters and factors, right? That's when I realized that these sort of stories or ideas actually makes much more sense for the retail investors, right? Because at that point of time in India, like, retail investors only had two options to invest or to access the capital markets. Either they can go buy stocks directly or they can buy mutual funds, right? And both, according to me, are not the very best options, right? So we thought of coming up with the idea of a small case, right? And we say that it's much better compared to single stocks, because it's obviously providing you the diversification benefit of a portfolio. At the same time, we say that it is much better than the mutual funds, because it's much more transparent, easy to understand, relatable, and most of the time cost efficient also.
Anugrah, tell us about how Smallcases actually implements smart beta. For those of you who aren't familiar with Smallcases, it's a basket of stocks or ETFs intelligently weighted to reflect an idea, theme, or strategy. Smallcases are created by SEBI-registered professionals and is integrated with leading brokerages. This enables investors to buy multiple stock portfolios in one click.
So smart beta small cases fall in the quantitative category, where our research team has actually built these smart beta strategies with a lot of hard work and backtesting and offered it on our platform, right? So there are different types of smart beta strategies which are available. So currently there are three types of strategies, right? One which is based on low risk, another which is based on quality, and the third one is based on dividends, okay? So when I say that, okay, this is based on dividend, quality, or let's say risk, this essentially in technical terms means what, based on a particular factor. That because the way we determined smart beta was that we are using a particular factor to decide the weight of the stock in the portfolio, which is what essentially makes it a smart beta. That the same set of stocks as the benchmark but different weights, right? So at a small case, all the smart beta strategies focus on large cap stocks. We only include top 150 market cap stocks. From these stocks, we select certain stocks either on the basis of low risk or on the basis of quality or on the basis of dividend. Then we smartly weigh them completely different from the traditional benchmarking methodologies to offer better risk-adjusted return portfolios to the investors.
Great. So why should an investor go to you? You know, I'm a really smart guy.
Yeah.
I go to nseindia.com and I have the constituents of the Nifty and I just jiggle around with it. I can make my own portfolio. What exactly does Smallcases offer that's so compelling to me as an investor?
Sure. So there are two parts to it. First is obviously the research is going into it, right? And the second is implementation. So let's talk about both of them. Okay, first about whether you can actually quickly build a smart beta strategy, right? You can just take the same stocks, weigh them differently, and you have a smart beta strategy. I completely agree, right? But you don't know whether actually that strategy works or not, right? So what we have done here is that we have done historical or actually very rigorous aggressive backtesting for last 10 years, 15 years to check whether this strategy works in all sort of economic scenarios, whether it is a downturn or whether it's an upturn, whether the strategy is able to significantly outperform the benchmark or not, right? And that is something which it'll be very difficult for an individual retail investor to determine by themselves, right? And at the same time, the methodology in which the weights are decided are very quantitative and sophisticated in nature, right? So that's the advantage of coming to the small case platform and using these strategies, that all the research which ideally should go into determining the set of stocks and the related weights is already offloaded on someone else, which are our research analysts, right? So you get a ready-made portfolio, right? Now coming to the second question, right? Let's say someone just gives you this ready-made portfolio, right? You can go to your broker and execute it, right? But if you are going to a broker and executing it by buying through a small case, the execution is very, very seamless. You can just buy it in two clicks, and once you have bought it, you can very seamlessly track it. But at the same time, if you buy it on a small case, there is constant tracking happening by the research analyst also, and they will be reviewing it on a quarterly or an annual basis depending upon the type of the small case, and the users get to know if any changes required in the portfolio.
Pretty smart. So tell me one thing, what kind of an investor should look at small cases or doing this, I would call it DIY investing? What in your opinion is, you know, the ideal investor for this kind of a strategy?
So I think anyone who's looking to get into a stock market, right, this is the perfect platform for them, right? So if you're very convinced with the idea of a smart beta, which I feel one should be if they want to start investing, right? Because either you can go completely active, which is definitely not advice for someone who is starting new to the market, right? Or you can completely like go passive. I've bought something, I'm not going to look at it for next 10 years. Never know what's going to happen to the portfolio, right? So I feel this is the best way, or which is the smart beta way of investing for someone new to start doing it, right? And when you are starting it, I think the most important thing is to determine how much of equity exposure you want, right? Let's say if you've decided that, okay, I want to invest 10,000 in the market or 50,000 in the market. Once that has happened, I think then that amount of money should directly be going into the smart beta small cases, because these are small cases which consist of large cap stocks. They're very less risky, and the best part is at this lesser or same level of risk, they are offering you better returns. It's what we call better risk adjusted returns.
Anugrah, thank you so much for joining us. And that's a wrap on the Small Cases show. We hope you found this interesting. My guest today was Anugrah Srivastav, Head Investment Products at Small Case. In case you want to know more, reach out to us on www.smallcase.com. Stay tuned for the next episode where we bring you more investment strategies to help you make smarter investment decisions.